Today, we're looking at an independent test of an LED grow light. Last year, we looked at the Transcend T5 replacement bulbs. These LEDs replace the individual bulbs within an existing 4-foot T5 light fixture. But what if you don't already own a T5 system? Well, today, we'll look at the Infinity Linear LED. Thrive Agritech was generous enough to send me two of these bad boys. A single Infinity Linear is able to replace two high-output 4-foot T5 bulbs. That's the claim, at least. So I'll run them head-to-head against my T5s to see if they live up to the hype. Let's look at how I'm configuring these. I'm trying to structure a fair test against some T5s, so ideally, the LEDs will be placed side by side. I expect two Infinities to keep up with a 4-bulb T5 system. But how far should these be placed from the plants? Well, I spent a whole weekend with my Apogee SQ500 sensor, taking PPFD measurements. The T5s seemed brighter. Was this a realistic comparison after all? At a distance of 6 inches, the T5s were pushing 480 PPFD, too intense for my lettuce. But at a distance of 9 inches, the readings dropped to 333 PPFD. That extra space is good too because of all the heat this throws. The Infinity Linears were only outputting 263 PPFD, but once I placed them at 6.75-inch centers, that went up to 283. It still seems a little unfair, but we'll give it a shot and see what we get. These were grown in a garage that is not climate controlled. Not by design, but simply how things worked out. We have 4 hydroponic lettuces on each side, identical nutrients in all trays, half mixed from rainwater and the others from tap water. Here are the details for the test bed. The lettuce seedlings were thinned for matching vigor after a week of germination. And then the test was underway. After week 1, all plants looked fine. At week 2, we had even better growth. The LEDs produced longer leaves. Would these plants become thin and spindly? Well, after completing week 3, the Infinity Linears looked quite promising. At day 22, one of the trays under the T5 felt very light. Our solution was running low. Time to conclude the test. The LED plants appear bigger, but the T5s have a deeper color. The pigments are more concentrated, perhaps due to light levels, heat response, or even spectral composition. On both sides, there were slight signs of tip burn, but it was not severe, and most leaves looked healthy. Roots looked healthy in all samples, but the LEDs produced a more extensive root system. Time to weigh these and measure the remaining solution. And here's a fancy chart to show all recorded data, plant weights, even info about our nutrient solution. Now for the fun part, where we get to make graphs. First up, look at how much extra growth we got under the Infinity Linear LEDs. The T5s produce an average plant size of 95 grams, but look at the boost under those LEDs, 129 grams. Next, look at the contrast in water consumption. A significant increase under fluorescent, but the plants weren't using the water for growth. Instead, this must have been caused by increased heat levels. You could look at the growth versus water consumption side by side. See that direct correlation under the LEDs? Larger plants, more water use. Under the LEDs, these plants appear to be using just what they need for tissue production and growth. To get a rough idea of just how much water is required to produce the plant mass, this graph overlay is more to scale. So, let's sum up our key data points. The Infinity Linear LEDs were able to boost lettuce growth by 36%, but those plants used 36% less water. All the while in my test bed, the LEDs consumed 36% less power. Speaking of power consumption, how much did it cost to run this test? This shows the total cost for each light. Going further, we can compare how much growth was extracted per light, looking at the cost difference per gram or ounce. When it's all said and done, switching to these LEDs gave me twice the harvest per dollar spent on electricity. Keep in mind, though, that this test was designed to compare two infinities to four T5s. In reality, though, these LEDs are not just some T5 replacements. They bring much more to the table. That includes some amazing flexibility in the way they can be configured. Is it possible to extract even more growth per watts consumed? I suspect so, and that's what I'm testing next. Already, though, I'm quite happy with what I've seen. Thrive Agritech has done a great job in their production of these infinity linears. Something to note, the models I tested boast an efficiency of 2 micromoles per joule, but this has been upgraded to 2.2 micromoles. Improvements are always coming along, but who should buy one of these units? Certainly, these lights are perfect for seed starting, lettuce, microgreens, plant cloning. These are great for home gardeners, but especially for growth chambers, tissue culture labs, greenhouses, and vertical farms. The waterproof construction is ideal for hydroponic, aeroponic, or even aquaponic installations. If this LED seems like something that will suit your needs, I certainly can recommend it. I really appreciate your support on my channel. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, happy gardening.